Good morning, students. Let's continue chapter 6. Today's topic is completing exercise 6.5. Students, some important questions. Question number 18. A rectangular sheet of tin 45 cm by 24 cm is to be made into box without top. By cutting off square from each corner and folding up the flaps, what should be the side of the square to be cut off so that volume of box is maximum? So first of all, there is a rectangular sheet. Okay, so first try to understand by this figure. Okay, and there is cutting of a square from each corner. So let's here one corner, it's another, and third, and we have to make a box. Okay, fourth corner, and then the length and breadth are given. Length is 45 centimeter and here width is its remaining 24 centimeter. Okay, now we have to find the volume of this box. So first of all, let x centimeter is side of square cutting from each corner. Okay, so now length would be here, this is x. Okay, side of this square is x, same as here, this is x, and same here, these all side of square is x. Okay, now we have to find this length. Okay, from here it would be this, only this one, it would be 45 minus 2x centimeter. Okay, and now breadth, it is 24 minus 2x centimeter. Okay, and height is x centimeter. These are the dimension of a box. So you can write box dimension. Okay, now we have to find the volume. Since it is required in the question that volume of the box is maximum. Okay, so first volume, it is length into breadth into height. So here length is 45 minus 2x and it is 24 minus 2x and height is x. Now multiply this, it is 45, 24 into x minus, from here it is 48x square. Okay, and now it is minus 90x square and it is plus 4x cube. Okay, so you will get a function in x. It is 4x cube and minus, from here it is 138x square, and term of x you will get 1080x. Okay, and now student, it is the volume in term of x. Find dv by dx, first order derivative. You will get 12x square, from here it is minus 138 into 2 into x, and it's plus 1080. Now solve it. It is 12x square minus and 2. 80. Now we have to find the value of x. But first I am finding d square v by dx square. Okay. You will get 24x minus 276. Now students, take dv by dx is equal to 0. Okay. So from this equation, you will get x is equal to 5 or 18. You solve it by middle term split. You will get two values of x, 5 and 18. But if x is 18, substitute in this form, it is 24 minus 36. Okay, so it's less than 0. It means x is not equal to 18. So we have only one value of x. It is 5. Okay. Now we have to check that at this value, volume is maximum or not. Okay. So for this, it is the last part. Okay. So now substitute value of x in the d square v upon dx square. So d square v by dx square at x is equal to 5, you will get it is 24 multiplied by 5 minus here it is 276. Okay, so it is minus 276. It means less than 0. It is negative. Less than 0, it means volume is maximum at x is equal to 5. You have to write that volume is maximum at x is equal to 5 centimeter. Okay. So question is simple, but we have to understand from this problem that how make the function. First, you have to make the function in one variable only. Okay. And then first derivative, second derivative, and find the value of the variable. Okay, here variable is x, so that we are finding the value of x. Then after, check whether the volume is maximum or minimum, or whatever it is given in the question. Accordingly, you have to test the conditions. Okay, now students, move for the next question. Okay, and according to question, here it is volume of box is maximum. So first we find the volume. Okay. In the next question, the concept will be more clear. Okay. Let's start question number 19 of exercise 6.5. In the previous question, student, I by mistake done here 5.6, but it is also from 6.5. Question is, show that of all rectangles inscribed in a given fixed circle, the square has the maximum area. So first, from the question, we have to find the function in one variable. Now, from question, you see that here the circle is fixed. It means radius is constant, not a variable. Now, according to the question, figure of this left, this is the circle. Okay. And rectangles inscribed in a fixed circle. So here, this is the rectangle. Okay. Circle is fixed. Suppose it's the center and radius is A, and here is the perpendicular. Now rectangle is A, B, C and D. Okay. And this is point M. AM is take X and OM it's take Y. Okay. So now let A, B, C and D is a rectangle. Now we have to take the length and breadth. Okay. So here AM is X. So AB, this whole is a 2x. Okay, AB and C, and same as here, it's y, so whole this is 2y. Okay, so length is 2x of rectangle and breadth is 2y. And first thing, area of rectangle. Let it is S. Then area is 2x into 2y. Length into breadth. You will get, student, 4xy. Now it is the function of two variable, x and y. So we have to eliminate one variable. So for this, take triangle OAM. Okay. And according to this triangle, here x square plus y square is equal to a square. Okay. By Pythagoras. Now y is equal to under root a square minus x square. Okay. So here substitute the value of y. You will get s is equal to 4x and here a square minus x square. Now it is the function of a one variable. And find ds by dx, first order derivative. The question is tough only up to here. When you will get the proper function, there is no any difficulty. The procedure is same. Find function, first derivative, second derivative, and from the first derivative is equal to 0, find the value of x and then substitute in the second order derivative. And check whether the given function is maximum or minimum at which value. So here, take differentiate, it is 4. X become 1, derivative of x. So here a square minus x square and plus. Now x take as it is and derivative of under root a square minus x square. It is 1 by 2 under root a square minus x square. Now derivative of minus x square. It is minus 2x. Okay. Now simplify. So 2 will cancel. Take LCM. You will get a square minus x square. And here it is minus x square under root a square minus x square. Okay. So 4. And it is a square minus 2x square. And here under root a square minus x square. Okay. And now find second order derivative d square s by dx square. Okay. So from here you can apply the multiply rule or division rule. Okay. So take as it is. Here I am applying the multiply rule. So under root a square minus x square keep as it is and derivative of this numerator. It is minus 4x. Okay. And here a square minus x square power minus 1 by 2. Okay. Now plus a square minus 2x square is as it is and derivative of this it is minus 1 by 2 and here a square minus x square power minus 3 by 2 and minus 2x. Okay. Derivative of x square also here. So you will get here it is 4. From here it is minus 4x by under root a square minus x square. Okay. And from here 2 will cancel, minus minus becomes a plus only. And it is a square minus 2x square and here a square minus x square power 3 by 2. Okay. And now find value of x from ds by dx. Okay. So write here. Now ds by dx is equal to 0. So it is 4 a square minus 2x square by under root a square minus x square is equal to 0. This term will go in 0, student. Okay. Multiplication will be 0. So you will get here a square minus 2x square. Okay. Is equal to 0. So a square is equal to 2x square. And x is equal to a by root 2. Okay, take only positive value since it is the length, okay, x. So x by root 2, it is the value of x. And now find the value of y. When x is equal to a by root 2, so from this y is equal to under root. So now from y is equal to under root a square minus x square, take x is equal to a by root 2, you will get y is equal to also a by under root 2. Okay, both are equal. It means this rectangle is a square. Okay, now we have to check that at this value d square s by dx square is maximum or minimum. So substitute x is equal to a by under root 2 in d square s by dx square. Okay, you note down this in your notebook. Now for the next step, d square s by dx square, it is 4 minus 4 and in place of x it is a by under root 2. Okay, in the denominator also here a square minus it is a square by 2, then plus it's a square minus 2x square. So 2 into a square by 2 multiplied by x means a by root. Okay, and the denominator it is a square minus a square by 2 whole power 3 by 2. Now solve it. Okay, here 2 will cancel. A square minus a square, it becomes, this becomes 0. Okay, from here you will get minus 16. Okay, a by root 2. And from here it is 2a square minus a square means a square. Okay, so it is root 2 by a. Finally, you will get minus 16. It is less than 0. Okay, so at x is equal to a by root 2, area of rectangle is maximum and x is equal to a by root 2, y is equal to a by root 2. So all rectangles are squares. Okay, so you have to write rectangle are squares. Okay, questions are lengthy students, so I will cover 3 or 4 questions in one video. Okay, you practice the all questions. If you have doubt, then ask. Question number 25, show that the semi vertical angle of cone of the maximum volume and of given slant height is tan inverse under root 2. So from the question student, it is clear that there is a cone and we have to find the volume, since here volume is maximum. Okay, so from this question, first pick a figure of, so let is the cone. Okay, here height is h, slant height is a. Okay, and this angle is theta, is 90. Okay, and it's r radius. O a b and c, we can write the name. Okay, and now volume of the cone, volume of cone, it is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Here we can eliminate any variable, okay, either r or h. So from the triangle OBC, you have R is equal to under root L square minus H square. Okay. So here write the value of R. It is 1 by 3 pi R square means L square minus H square into H. Now 1 by 3 pi is the constant. Multiply with H. So here L square H minus H cube. Now it is the function of variable H only. Since here it is given that in the question that given slant height is this. It means it's a constant. Now student, take one order derivative. Okay. So now dv by dh. Derivative with respect to h. You will get 1 by 3 pi right as it is. From here it is L square minus 3h square. And next find d square v by dh square. So 1 by 3 pi right as it is. And from here it is minus 6h. Okay, since L is a constant. Now dv by dh take is equal to 0. Okay, so you will get pi by 3 L square minus 3H square is equal to 0. It will gives H square is equal to L square by 3. Okay, so H is equal to L by under root 3. Okay, is the value of H. And now check whether at this value volume is maximum or minimum. So next step, d square v by dh square at the point h is equal to l by under root 3. Okay, it is minus 1 by 3 pi. Okay, and 6h. 6h is l by root 3. So see, it is already negative, less than 0. It means volume is maximum at h is equal to l by under root 3. Okay, so now we have to find the angle theta, tan theta. So we need the r. Okay, since tan theta is equal to its r by h, and it's clear now that volume is maximum when h is equal to l by root 3. Okay, now find r. I have to rub this, student. You note in your notebook. Okay, so r is equal to under root l square minus h square. Here h square is l square by 3. Okay, so it is 2 by 3 l square. Okay, or you can write here is under root 2 by 3 into l. And now find the tan theta. Okay, now tan theta is equal to r by h from this triangle, student. Okay, now write the value of r and h. You will get, and here h is l by root 3. Okay, so it's only root 2. Okay, root 3 will cancel. So theta is equal to tan inverse under root 2. Okay, and now last you have to write the statement that when slant height is L or it is a constant, then semi vertical angle of the cone is theta is equal to tan inverse root 2. Okay, solve the question number 23. Prove that volume of largest cone that can be inscribed in a sphere of R, it is the radius of sphere, is 8 by 27 of volume of sphere. Okay, So first of all, students, here according to the question that it is the sphere and it's the largest cone. In the sphere, okay, and that this is the center of the sphere, now it's given that radius is r, it is also r, and that it is the point B, okay, and it's the radius R and here angle theta. Now let R is radius of cone, okay, and R it is the radius of sphere, it is given, okay students. Now volume of cone, it is 1/3 pi r square h, okay, so here 1/3 pi. Now r square, and now height of this cone, so it is, height is r plus ab, okay, from the figure you see that here it is, suppose here it is c, okay, so height of cone is ac plus ab, okay, and here AC, it is the radius of the sphere, so it's R, and plus AB, okay. Now we have to find the AB, so from this triangle, okay, AB, suppose here it is D, so from this triangle we can find the value of AB, so it is R plus under root R square minus R square, okay. So right here 1/3 pi r square, and here it is r plus, and ab is, it is the height, okay, so r plus under root r square minus r square. Now 1/3 pi r square into r, and here 1/3 pi r square into r square minus r square. Now it is the function, okay, in one variable, in which variable, is small r, since capital R is fixed, okay, it means it is the constant, so you have to take the derivative with respect to small r. So first find, students, dv by dr, okay, dv by dr, you will get 1/3 pi 2 r into r plus, from here apply the multiply rule, okay, so 1/3 pi, first r square, so 2 r, and here r square minus r square, keep as it is, then 1/3 pi r square, okay, and now derivative of this, under root r square plus 1 by r square, it is 1/2 under root r square minus r square into minus 2 r, okay, and in the next step take dv by dr is equal to 0 and find the value of r, okay, you solve it, student, simplify, it would be easy, okay, so from this you will get r square is equal to 8/9 r square, okay, if you got any difficulty tell me, okay, I will help you, and then after find d² v/dr² okay, at the point this r is equal to here 8/9 r, okay, and it would be less than 0, solve it and then you will find this, and now the next, Here we have been found out R. We have to find the H to find the volume. Since the question is that volume is 8 by 27 of volume of a sphere. So we have to find the volume of cone. Okay. So now find the value of H. Here H is R plus under root, it's R square minus R square, and it is 8 by 9 R square. Solve it. You will get from here it is R by 3. Okay. Since 9 minus 8 R square, it's R square. Solve it. And now 4 R by 3. Okay. Now find the volume. 1 by 3 pi R square. Here R square is 8 by 9 R square. Okay. And H is 4 R by 3. Now arrange it. 8 by 9 3 is a 27. Okay. And from here we can write, so 4 by 3 pi R cube. Okay. And it is the volume of sphere. Okay. So next step, 8 by 27, and it is the volume of sphere. Okay. Hence proved.